Yes, welcome to the 32nd Legislative District. And we're in this parking lot because Puhan Plaza, this shopping mall, is one of my most favorite.
And what are we drinking?
We are drinking a rice punch, non-alcoholic. Sweet,
that's
isn't
good.
It? It's good, isn't it?
Well, you've had an amazing story in your road to Olympia and the road down Aurora where we are right now. It starts in South Korea, right?
It does. For me, it's South Korea. For my parents, it's North Korea. South Korea in those days, in the 60s, was very poor, actually even more poor than North Korea, since it's changed quite a bit.
And how do you decide as a family to settle in Lewis County?
Gate, Washington, which is a suburb of Rochester, Washington, which is a suburb of Centralia, Washington.
And you went to Centralia High School.
I did. I'm a Centralia Tiger.
You were one of three members of your class that were people of color, is that
yes.
right?
Yes, or the entire high school, actually. We didn't have babysitting or summer camp in those days, right? So everybody went out to the blueberry field and picked for several hours.
There's one element of that story that I find fun, is that you don't smoke.
No.
But you said you always kept a cigarette around and it came yes. in handy while you were yeah. working in the fields.
Yeah. Shredded tobacco, most easily portable in a cigarette. You just open it up, press it against a bleeding wound, and it stops the bleeding. Get that little cigarette that daddy's collecting, open it up, compress it. So I was the de facto nurse.
So tobacco stops bleeding.
It does.
Otherwise, it's bad for your health.
Oh, yeah. Just don't smoke it. Just apply it.
Then you come to this area, to Snohomish County,
right.
King County,
right.
Shoreline.
We had a tiny little office in Shoreline where our insurance agency was. So I would go to the city council meetings and got involved with the Shoreline Merchants Association.
And you became the first Korean American woman elected mayor in the entire country?
In the whole USA, yep.
And do you think that your upbringing and everything that we talked about, do you think that had anything to do with your drive and your perseverance to do this?
I think so.
So this road that we're sitting on here with the noise in the background, that's important to your story as well?
Very. That is exactly why I became a politician.
Between Aurora and the business development here in the Korean American community.
Highway 99 is a highway of importance for commerce, for us to get back and forth.
So how do you think your experience has translated into becoming another first, the first Korean American woman elected to the Washington State Legislature?
It's been, this is my 11th year in the legislature. I have cousins that live in South Korea and I have cousins that live in North Korea. And you know, I ask, hey, which do you think I like the best? As imperfect as the U.S. democracy is, I like the American democracy. I feel like I'm part of the solution.
I think the cultural awareness in the last few months has risen about attacks on Asian Americans. How are you viewing what has transpired?
I am asking everyone, please continue to talk about it. It's super hard to talk about hate, especially against a particular group, but you know, by extension, it's about every other person who might not feel like they belong, right?
Well, you have lived the American dream. You have taken us down a road. It's been a pleasure sitting here with a trailblazer. You're a trailblazer.
Thank you.
Thank you for sharing a drink with
yes,
me.
Thank you.
And introducing me to Rice
yes.
Punch.
Yes, Rice Punch. No alcohol. It's good, huh?
I like it.